Hello and welcome to today's video. In this tutorial, I want to show you how to design a wrist yarn hanger in Autodesk Fusion. These hangers are great when you're traveling and want to crochet or knit, and they're very easy to design. First step is obviously to open Fusion and start a sketch. Place the sketch on the XY plane, this one here, which will put you into the top view. Next step is to draw a circle. Place it in the center of your sketch and make it 130 mm. Perfect. Click on Finish Sketch. And now click within your circle and select Extrude. Make this one 5 mm thick. This will be the base. Now, place a sketch on the space and draw another circle in the center and make it 15 millimeter. Finish sketch again. Select this. Extrude. And make it 200 millimeter. Like this. Make sure operation is set to join so they will merge into one body. Click OK. Perfect. Now click here at this intersection point between the plate and the dowel. Click here and then select fillet. So now, as you can see, we can create a radius. Make it 10 millimeter and click OK. This will make sure we will have a smooth print. And it will also strengthen the connection between these two. Okay, now scroll up to the top of the dowel. Select the corner again and click Fillet again. If you select 7.5 millimeter, you will have a perfect orb here. And then click OK. You can make it smaller if you want to. And the last step for this design is to drill a hole through here. To do this, go to Origin, click on this eye. And then we need to select one of the planes that go through the center of the dowel, like this. So you can see it's in the center here. Click on Sketch and select this plane, which is XZ. And it will rotate the view to this. Now select Circle again. Place it on this line. As you can see, it was snapped to it. Make this circle 6 millimeter. I'll better make it 8. This will depend on what you want to hang on it. If you want to use something thicker, make this wider. And if you use something very thin, you can make this hole smaller. Next step is to add a dimension. From the center of the circle to the bottom, like this. Drag it out and place it somewhere. And change it to 195. Enter. Okay, as you can see, it's now up here at the top. Click Finish Sketch. Rotate your view a bit, like this. Okay, now to cut this hole, we will select Extrude again. Select the profile. Go over here to Direction. Change it over to Symmetric. And then Distance. Type in 10. And make sure Operation is Cut. So it will now cut a hole through this. Click OK. And now you can see the hole. If you now find that this hole is a bit too far at the top, you can just go into your sketch, click on it, double click, and change this dimension to 190. Maybe 193. Yeah, I prefer to be slightly under the curve. Perfect. And this is it. You can now hide away the origins again, so it will hide the planes. And this is all you have to do for this model. One last thing I would like to do is to add a fillet to this curve here. Select it again, click fillet, and drag it out. Drag it until you're happy. I will just go with 2.5 millimeter. Done. Okay, that's it. It's all done for 3D printing. To export, click on utilities and make. Select the body and click OK. Save it to your computer and print it on your 3D printer. So my printer is a Bambu Lab A1 and it works with Bambu Studio, which is this software here. I will add my design and leave every setting on the standard setting. Click on slice. And that is it. No issues, no support, nothing. When you're ready, click on print. This is my Bambu Lab A1. I've got it a few months ago. The print took about 2.5 to 3 hours. It turned out pretty smooth. What do you think? The underside looks amazing. To assemble this, I will use these key rings, the swivel key rings, and a piece of ribbon I had left over. Attach the keyring to the top hole, like this. And then hook this to the ribbon. And that's all you have to do. Very easy to assemble. And now you can add your yarn. I will just use this one and poke a hole in the middle and stuff it over. Pour the ribbon through and now you're good to go. You can now hang it on your wrist and use it on the go. I hope you liked this video, and if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Please also like and subscribe if you want to see more of these kind of video. Thanks for watching. Bye.